Hey, this is Danielle DeLate for the New Music Buzz, and on today's show, we're on the red carpet for Range 15. We talk to Jordan Sparks, and we have a live performance from Corinne Bailey-Ray. And in our artist spotlight, we have Andy Vargas. So let's get this show started. Roll that intro. Recently, Kira caught up with Jordan Sparks on the green carpet of Amazon's All or Nothing premiere, where she talked football and her new project. So let's check it out.
You come from an NFL family and you are from Phoenix. How proud are you of your team?
I'm very proud. I've always been proud. Yes, I have a certain allegiance to, I won't even name their name because it's about the Cardinals today, but I have an allegiance to the team that my dad played for, of course. But Arizona Cardinal Red just runs through my blood, you know, that team, the stadium, all the people, the staff, everybody. For me, you know, it's a lot of amazing memories. Like, I grew up with this team. And to watch that, it just reiterated why I love to root for this team so much. They're amazing football players, yes, they're incredible, they persevere, but they're great human beings as well, and they're really great to each other. You can tell that they're a family and that they really try and make each other better and hold each other accountable and really try and make the team best. There's no I anywhere. You can't see an I anywhere in there. And it's really, really great. I think people are really going to enjoy the series.
Well, we all know that you came from one of the biggest reality shows in the world. Yes. And now they're doing All or Nothing, a season with the Arizona Cardinals. I mean, what can you relate with this team?
Oh, man. Well, it was funny because they just did a Q&A, and Bruce was like, the only thing that was annoying was putting the microphones on every day. And I was like, yep, that's the thing. You're just like, I don't want to have this pack on, and it gets hot sometimes. And, you know, the cameras can sometimes be a little intrusive, but at the same time, if it's every single day, you kind of just forget they're there and you get used to it. You learn how to maneuver and go around. So I think now what they need to prepare for is how many new fans they're going to have after this whole series airs, because it's going to be really, really great for them.
You know, I personally am not a big football fan, but I watched this trailer. I watched this trailer and it hooked me.
Yes, I think for anybody who's not necessarily a football fan or kind of just doesn't get it, I think this would be a great intro for people who don't really understand the game. They're going to get the ins and outs of the game. They're going to get to see the locker room, which most people don't ever get to see. They're going to get to see how the team's actually interact with each other. Look how tall this guy is. You get to see how big they really are. They're big dudes. And then you also get to see the heart. You know, they have their struggles too. They have their good days, they have their bad days, and for me, I relate to them because as a performer or an athlete or an entertainer of sorts, you have to push all that aside and just go and do what you do. You just go and do your job, or you use it as fuel, whatever it is, but you still kind of have to compartmentalize and leave it and just go and perform for your fans. They have 70,000 fans in that stadium every week, you know, cheering for them, rooting for them, watching them play and perform on that field. And it's really intense, but I think they do an amazing job of it. But I think people are going to love it whether they're a fan of the game or not.
I love seeing how passionate you are about this.
Thanks. I really am. People are like, oh, what do you know about football? I'm like, come here. Let's talk. Let's just come here and sit down. Let's talk.
Maybe Jordan Sparks can give me the 101 on football.
We can sit. We'll go to a game. I'll help you out. We'll go to the bar and we'll just watch some games and it'll be good.
You guys heard it here.
It'll be great.
So wait, can I ask what are you doing in music right now?
What am I doing in music? Weekend this month, I have shows, and I actually am getting prepared for going to New York to shoot a show that got picked up on ABC.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. I'm excited. I'm really excited. It's a recurring guest role. It's called Time After Time. And it's based on H.G. Wells' Time Machine and Jack the Ripper Comes to Modern Day New York. Anyway, there's a trailer online. You can watch that. But I'm excited to do that. It's going to be fun. So music is still happening. I'm still determining on what I want to do this year. I put out an album last year called Right Here, Right Now. So if you'd like, you can go pick that up. It has Cardinals colors in it. It's got black and red, actually, if you look closely. But I put that out, and so we're just going to see what direction I want to go this year. So. Hey guys, I'm Jordan Sparks, and you've just been Buzz.
Memorial Memorial Day just passed and it's the unofficial start of the summer. Chanel was recently on the red carpet at the Range 15 movie premiere, which was created by military veterans. Let's check it out.
Hey everybody, I'm Chanel Herlin here for the New Music Buzz at the Vista Theatre for the Range 15 premiere. The red carpet is about to start, so let's check it out.
Good afternoon, Mr. Best.
What's Range 15?
It's a fallback point for an ELE.
Shit. I'm not gonna leave the fate of the world to you fuck-offs.
I prefer my guy.
Keep your ears buttered up, while I set fire to the range.
So why are we going to Range 15?
That's where the scientists are and we have the cure.
Stay away from the glass.
If this was a zombie movie, you'd be getting ripped through that glass right about now.
This is a zombie movie!
Look, Matt, sometimes things can look pretty bleak.
How is it working on this film, Range 15?
It's different from other projects because the only people on the project are people that want to do it. You know, and in Hollywood, you get that douchebag act, Gary Busey, who's just doing it for the paycheck, Gary Busey. And, you know, no one wants to work with him. He's miserable. But no, everyone wanted to be part of it. Everyone was happy. The background, it didn't matter how hot it was or how much makeup they had on, they were happy to be there. And from the beginning to the fundraising to the theaters, 241 theaters and counting that it's going to play at, that doesn't happen for independent film without a lot of love and support behind it. And, you know, in a time where we're so divided, it's nice to see everyone get behind veterans and the military and America.
Yes, America. And now, what attracted you to the script? What brought you onto the project initially?
I think Ross recommended me, and then Jared called me. And they're like, oh, you know, the script. And they sent me the script, and I read it, and I loved it. I'm a comedic actress, and I like messed up. I'm messed up in real life. I'm probably not acting. I'm probably only acting when I have to be serious or I have to do CSI or something. I'm, like, serious. You know, I love messed up humor. That's me every day. And hopefully I hold my own. I know it's a military comedy, but I'm excited. I haven't seen it yet. I mean, I was there, but I haven't actually, like, seen the film. I've missed all the other screenings, so I'm kind of excited.
So tell me about the film. What is your involvement?
I play the Colonel's daughter and one of the very many love interests of Matt Best. And there's a keys scene. That's about it.
And what was it like working with Matt?
Well, I know him, so pretty normal.
No starstruck moment there.
Oh, God, no.
And what was it like working on the film?
It was nerve-wracking. It's the first film I've ever been in, but it was a lot of fun. Everybody was very down to earth, and I got to meet a lot of stars from my childhood that I was starstruck by.
So tell me, Russ, this is an incredible project, and to see such an amazing support here tonight, are you able to just relax and enjoy your film, or are you still quite critical of your work?
Yeah, no. I smoked a ton of weed in the parking lot, so I feel great. Like, I feel really great. I love these lights. Like, yeah. No, it's great. You look fantastic.
Oh, you look fantastic. Yeah, I'm loving that gray cap.
Thank you so much. It was about 98 degrees today. No Nick Lachey, pun intended, but I was really sweating. So I went Ken Griffey Jr. on it.
Okay.
Threw the hat on backwards.
Oh gosh, well at least it's cooled down a bit now for you guys to watch the movie in a bit of peace.
A nice breeze is picked up. A nice Australian breeze is picked up. So
I'm not from Australia, but nice
neither.
Try.
Me neither. I'm not either. Well, who says we can't both love the same continent?
Exactly.
Continent love is blind. It really is.
Now tell me, what was it like working with your cast during the process of the film?
They were amazing. Yeah, they were amazing. Whenever you get to work with, U.S. military veterans, I don't want to sound shitty or cliche about it, but they're just harder workers than like normal people. So they're never late. They're always on time. They always want to rehearse. Like, it's a blast. I wish everybody was like that. But usually everybody's lazy and they're like, "Fuck, I want your sandwich." Why is your sandwich bigger than mine? Why is your trailer bigger than mine? I still want that sandwich. And then they'll go back to the sandwich. And you're like, Jesus, man, lay off the sandwich.
Oh my goodness.
Like, I get it, you know?
Now, what is up next for you? Now that this film is done, Range 15, what's happening next?
Holy cow. So I wrote a book that came out last year. It was a bestseller called A Night She Cries While He Rides a Steed. It was the first ever romance novel for dudes. So I have to write the sequel to that. And then probably, more than likely, a sequel to this.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we expect a movie from the book that you're writing?
I hope. That's a big budget. That's a really big budget. And I got to get a lot more famous. So if this does well opening weekend, yeah, maybe. If not, probably not.
Well, it looks like it's going to do incredibly well. So congratulations and really nice to meet you.
I really appreciate it. It was nice to meet you too.
We'll be back with more Buzz after these messages.
It's the return of the boom, return of the box. Bass so low you can feel it when it drops. Indoor, outdoor, powered by Monster. A blast from the past so you know it's gonna rock ya. But we back to the future with this one. We pump up the volume and you know you gon' get one. The Monster Blaster, it's what we call it. It's the Subwoofer King for your boomaholics. Come on everybody, let's all get down. With powerful bi-directional sound. The bottom solo it vibrates the ground. From city to city and from town to town. So if you're hippin' or you're hoppin' or you're pop locking, working out to the beat and need the bass dropping. You're looking for an integrative subwoofer with twice the wattage. Say Monster products. Woo.
Check it out. Need fast cash? Well, go to cityloan.com or call 877-553-9071 to borrow $3,000 or more using the equity in your paid-off vehicle. The best part? No credit checks. Your car is your credit with City Loan. Over 99% of City Loan customers are in good standing every month. So call 877-553-9071 now. And get this, if you sign up today and you are approved for a loan, you will receive a $25 gift card from Target. Be sure to mention promo code TVAD to receive your gift card. Also, don't forget to like City Loan on Facebook at City Loan Community and follow us on Twitter at City Loan. Now back to the New Music Buzz.
My mom's getting overwhelmed here.
Oh, that's wonderful. So tell me, as an audience member, what can we expect from the film at Range 15?
That'd just be a good cutaway. A lot of intense comedy, you know? Like, we push the levels on the comedic aspect of this film, and I think that it's going to be a lot of fun and a lot of what people need in their life, you know?
And what was the process like from beginning, pre-production, all the way now till post-production? Lots of ups and downs, or was it pretty smooth sailing? How would you describe it?
I think anybody that's been in the production business knows it's a grind. We started this from day one. We wrote the process. Cheers, buddy. We wrote the film. We edited the film. We produced the film. So it's a grind, but at the end of the day, it made the film what we wanted it to be, which is kind of a narrative for what veterans should be and how our culture is. So we're super excited about it.
First of all, tell me about this picture.
Well, this is hopefully my best friend, The Rock. I love you. We should be together. Friends, though. No, I love the dude. I think he's an inspiration. I thought the outfit was outstanding, and I wanted to try and replicate it, so I feel like I did a good job.
You did a brilliant job. The jeans, the moon bag, the shirt, and the chain.
I missed the watch, yeah, but we're good.
Okay, so talking about music, how do you get in the zone for a day on set? Do you listen to music to pump you up?
I actually do, man. I'm one of those guys that if you see a lot of my social media, I always have a headset in somehow, some way. So depending on the mood, right, like depending on the scene, what we're doing, I'm either going to listen to soft music, some loud music, whatever it is. And we had a lot of awesome talent donate some music to us for this film. And it's been insane. I mean, guys like, The Hustle Standard, they donated some music for us. I mean, guys like a TMR, the Marine rapper. Like, we had so many people, like, just donate music for the film that worked perfect for what we were trying to do. So it's been a fun ride with the music itself. Yeah.
And what was it like working on set with such an incredible cast?
Yeah, it's a blessing. I mean, like I said, like most of us, this is the first time we've ever done anything like this. So for us, we're just kind of soaking it in and hope that we can replicate it down the road, because this is something we produced ourselves. I would love to do it again. It was a blast.
Can you tell me about your character in Range 15? What is he like?
I'm playing myself. I play a character called the Celebrity. Okay. They can see they change it. There were a guy, I think he makes a point of meeting me. And then we both take our clothes off, sit in the jacuzzi. Oh, sorry, wrong film. No. So we do a little dialogue together, and then he sees me at some restaurant or some event. It was such an honor to be in this. I'm just cracking up. Such an honor to be in this movie. My whole family was all veterans. My mom was in the OSS, and the Office of War Information during World War II. She was a spy. Yeah, my dad, all my uncles, they all fought wars, you know. I have two Purple Hearts. One died, one survived, but we had wounded his whole life, you know. interview.
No, my question was, how many adult films have you been in, Ron?
I have the world's record. I have another one. I've been in about 2,000 and over a couple of thousand adult movies. 33-year career. But also, no one knows this. I've been in 56 music videos. MTV, VH1, YouTube. I have the world's record. No one's even close. I've been in more music videos than Michael Jackson, everybody.
Well, on a music channel.
Yeah, I had one song that was a hit single called Freak of the Week with me, DJ Polo, and Ice-T on the backside. And it was called Freak of the Week. It was on Billboard 27 weeks.
Hey, man. Well, last
See, manly
question,
man. Ron. We hug like manly man.
Oh, you don't want to hear what he just told me earlier, though.
Oh, about sharing a jacuzzi
Matt,
with a guy.
Hey!
Hey, what's up, buddy? Man. Good, nice to see you there.
Aww, thank you.
Hi, it's Ron Jeremy, known as being a harmonica player and an actor, and violin player and a piano player. Go to Kid Rock's video, Cowboy. I'm the guy on the piano.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. Cowboy, I'm the guy playing with Josie and Gary Coleman duke it out, and I'm the guy on the piano. Because Kid Rock knew I played piano, so I played piano in that video. Yeah.
And can we say together, you have just been buzzed to the camera. One, okay. Two, three.
You have just been buzzed.
Thank you. Lovely to meet you. The red carpet is almost done. Range 15 is about to start. We've had quite an interesting night with some very interesting actors. I'm Chanel Herlin, and you've just been buzzed.
Up next, we have a live performance from Corinne Bailey-Ray after these messages.
Speaks and Whispers. We caught up with her at her live performance at Amoeba Records in Hollywood. Let's check it out.
Hey, how you doing? So many people came. So nice to see you all. So nice seeing so many kids as well. I never get to play when the kids are allowed to come. How are you doing out there? Well, thanks for coming. We're in town, we're playing some shows, and we're playing some radio stations, and we thought we'd call by Amoeba Records to support my new album, The Heart Speaks and Whispers. Yeah. So yeah, we want to play a few new songs from that, and maybe some old songs that you might know, so yeah, just get into it. Again, thanks for coming down. This song is called Been to the Moon.
Don't you recognize that I'll ask you?
The New Music Buzz is brought to you by Spinnable. View life in 360. City Loan, get cash for your car today. And Rockwell Watches, innovative design. For more music entertainment news, go to www.thenewmusicbuzz.com. In our artist spotlight, we have Andy Vargas, who has been singing with legendary musician Carlos Santana for 15 years. He is now working on a solo project, so let's check it out.
My name is Andy Vargas, and you're watching the Buzz Artist Spotlight. I started out in music with a gentleman named Terry Melcher, who lived in Carmel. The late Terry Melcher was Doris Day's son, and he gave me my first opportunity to record music in Carmel and beta test his new Pro Tools system. He had some amazing songs that he had me sing. That led to a record deal with RCA Records, and I was working under the guidance of Ron Fair at RCA for a few years in developing my artistic talents. I met Carlos in the year 1999, and I had an opportunity through friends in the music business, Ron Fair, Clive Davis, from Arista, who helped me audition for Carlos in San Rafael, California. And I stepped in, and literally before I knew it, I was singing Smooth by Rob Thomas, which was the first hit from the Supernatural record. And after a few songs, the decision was made for me to go out on a two-week tour, East Coast tour, and 3 days into the tour, Carlos had asked me to join the band. He goes, you're in. And lo and behold, here we are today. So 15 years later, I've always had my own musical inspiration and expression. And what I'm doing now is very focused, presenting my own music through my own independent company. At the same time, still in Santana Band, but while off tour, which is a good chunk of the year, I'm recording and writing and releasing my own music with my company called Soletos Records. And I've got a great team of people. Today is an independent day. And what I'd like to do is just express this music, to the world, to the universe, and have an opportunity to, have people accept and listen to it. So working with Carlos so long, I know that there's probably a perspective that I would feel pressured in, finding my own musical sound. But in working with Carlos, I found out that we're all the same, but we all have our own identity, and it takes people years and a lifetime to find that and find out how to express that. It's the distance between, your head and all the stuff that goes on in your head to your heart, and if you can connect to your heart and if you can express what's there. To me, defining your own sound, it's whatever inspires me. So I feel no pressure and no fear in expressing who I am and what I am. So I have a single that I'll be pushing and performing and singing out into the public. The song's called The Beat, and it's finished now. And what I'll be doing is I'll be releasing singles throughout the year. When I have the time to be able to go out and promote it, when I'm not performing with Carlos, I'll be doing that. The song is called The Beat. It talks about freeing your spirit through the music and not paying attention to what the media and people in this world are trying to manipulate your minds and doing. We found freedom from history through music, from John Lennon, to Bob Marley, and they've had their ways of expressing to release yourself and release your ego in, and find joy and peace in the music. And so I'm just trying to do my part right now and doing the same thing. So fans can find me on social media at Andy Vargas Music on Instagram, Twitter, and Andy Vargas Official on Facebook fan page. And you can also find me at andyvargas.com, where you can connect to my foundation, updates with Santana, all of the artists that I'm collaborating with, everyone coming together to follow and spread the same message and follow your own message and follow me. All right, peace, take care, and God bless. My name is Andy Vargas, and you've just been buzzed.
Entertainment news, go to www.thenewmusicbuzz.com. That's all we have. Special thanks to Reina Trevino, Nick Martinez, Chanel Hurlett, and Kira Lynn. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and double tap us on Instagram, all at The New Music Buzz. I'm Danielle DeLate, and I'll be back at you like a boomerang.
Peace out.